say the key takeaways, number one, spending down 13% year over year. I'd say the second piece was if you talk to teens about their view of the economy, 47% said it was getting worse. Just 1 year ago, that number was 28%. I would say the third piece is within their wallet, even though the budgets were down, food is 25% of their budget. So they still do care about that as a category. And then within apparel and footwear, Nike was the number one brand. I think you'll see a lot more casualization as people are working from home, students are being schooled from home. And then Lululemon was a significant uptake, now the number six brand.
What exactly were the brands that did not fare so well, the bottom of the list, so to speak?
Sure. So on the bottom of the list, from a category perspective, it was cosmetics. Cosmetics was down 26% in spend, and you saw a lot of move from kind of big established brands towards up-and-coming brands. In terms of apparel, brands that continue to linger, Ralph Lauren, Sperry Topsider, a few examples there, and then Under Armour. Under Armour was a brand that teens continue to cite that they no longer wear.
All right. Now, you mentioned the food side of things as well. It's obviously a very, very big component of the stay-at-home economy right now. People can only really go get takeout or drive-through or anything else. From a food perspective, was there any indication about some of the brands that really do stand out in terms of where these teens want to spend that 20 or so percent of their income on food?
So the number one restaurant is Chick-fil-A, and this has been the case for the last five surveys. So that one continues to take share. Starbucks number two, Chipotle number three. That one actually we saw a really nice uptick in share as well. So those have been kind of the food rankings in terms of where they're spending their time. And obviously, to your point, it really depends on if you can actually get the delivery and get the takeout. But, you know, clearly that's the way things are moving.
What exactly can you glean in terms of your coverage universe and industry expertise about what it will take to get consumers spending again, especially on the teen side of things, in the wake of what's happening with coronavirus? At what point, what signs of stabilization would you need to see to make you feel comfortable that this particular industry emerges in the next X weeks or months from this particular issue?
It's a great question. I mean, look, I think as you sit now, I mean, most retailers are closed at least through June here in the United States and in Europe. I think that the distinction of the winners versus the losers are those that have online and very strong digital, not just platforms, but connections with their consumers. People are going to be spending more time at home. They're going to be spending more time online. The average teen says they spend 12 hours a week on social media. I absolutely believe that goes a lot higher during this time and maybe structurally stays higher as well. So the names that we think are going to kind of weather this storm best, it's the Nikes of the world. It's the Lululemons of the world that really do can come out strong connections with their consumers, can engage in activities, whether it's in-home exercise or different kind of events online. I think they come out stronger at the end, but it's going to take time.